Colourwerx peeps. It is Linda, and this is...
Carl!
Gosh, we're so out of practice. And today is Friday, September 24th. This is our monthly Fab Friday program. So we've not been on the air for about 4 weeks, I think it is, or 3 weeks. But today is... Yeah, we still can't use our applause like sound effect there because we keep getting dinged by Facebook for copyright infringement for an applause sound effect, if you can believe it. Good morning, everybody. I see you all checking in. We've got Pat from North Carolina in Pinehurst, and we've got Sandra checking in from St. Louis. And I don't want to mispronounce your name there, Ms. Bailey, I'll call you. Hello from Maryland. And then Kim and Marianne and Benita and Bob. I'm going to wave to Bob over there in Palm Springs. So good morning, everybody. And Suzanne and Carolyn. You guys are so great. And Kay, you guys just keep checking in. Jen from Palm Springs as well. It's a beautiful day here in the desert. I must say, it is Friday, September 24th. It's episode number 44 of the Fab Friday program. We are now on a monthly schedule for our Fab Friday program. It is gorgeous, isn't it? All my desert oasis people out there, all you guys in Palm Springs and Palm Desert, isn't it gorgeous? We finally have gotten rid of pretty much most of the heat. We had some hot heat yesterday at about 105. Today is absolutely great. It's fall is here. We've got a slight breeze out there. The nights are getting cooler. It's just, this is the most wonderful time in the desert, I must tell you. It's just a great weather when the heat finally just disappears. And you can always tell because it's usually... preceded by a little bit of wind and some fluctuating temperatures that go around. You get cool and then you get hot and then you get cool again and then you get fall and it's gorgeous. So I'm super excited. It's my favorite time of year, of course. And so I welcome you all into episode 44 of Fab Friday. We have a nice tutorial today from Carl, of all people, for you. Carl has been busily paper piecing our topaz quilt sample that we're making of one of our new patterns. And so he has put together a paper piecing tutorial using this, which is the triangle pattern shape that's included in the topaz pattern. So if you did like that, and we'll talk about those patterns in just a minute, you will already be set up with a little tutorial from Carl. If you've never paper pieced or foundation pieced, it's a great step-by-step tutorial. If you need a refresher, it's a great step-by-step tutorial as well. So we'll be showing that in just a minute. We have to get on to the news of the day. Please like and share this video with all your quilty peeps. Make sure that you subscribe to our Colourwerx YouTube channel as well. And we have some business to get hold of. What's going on? Do we have Cactus Cam?
We do have
today?
Cactus.
There it is. Cloudy. Isn't it gorgeous out there? Now, you guys are probably going, what's going on with the green of the golf course? Well, they are scalping. They're doing their annual... scalping and reseeding of the golf course. So the course is going to close down in about a week. And when it does, then they really let all the grass die.
The camera is shaking
with the little wind. So they usually let all the grass die away, and then they reseed for the month of October to do a big opening tournament on November 1st. So that's why the green looks a little brown. It's not that they're not watering it. This is all on purpose. But it is gorgeous out there today. So we are
ecstatic. There's a couple of little ducks out there if you look.
Where?
Carl? Right there.
Oh, right by the pond.
On one end of the fountain.
So if you look just to the left of the fountain, I guess. You have to have a really keen eye, I guess. I don't really see that.
I don't know.
So good morning everybody checking in. Thank you so much for being here. The other thing we have to do is last month's winner. So remember last month, episode 43, we went through our Colourwerx fabric collection that just came out from Island Batiks, and we went through SKU by SKU and showed you the new patterns and showed you variations of patterns, of existing patterns we're using the Colourwerx collection. And the question of the week, or the question of the month, was what's your favorite Colourwerx SKU, and this month's winner, they're going to win a fat quarter bundle of the Colourwerx fabric line. So this month's winner is... Yay! Yay, April! Congratulations. So I will email you to get your shipping address. We'll be sending you off a fat quarter bundle of our Colourwerx collection. There it is, right on cue from Carl. And if you missed out getting this collection, we have more fabrics coming sometime in October. It might be as late as November at this point, depending on shipping delays, and there's a whole bunch of issues going on, as you've probably heard in the news, and all these things. Now, make sure you get to Costco, by the way, to get your paper towels and cleaning supplies. I guess I heard that this morning, that that you need to go get those. They've kind of broadcast to everybody that they're having delays. We have it on order, and we're just waiting for it to arrive. So with that speaking, we need to talk about also, what?
The quilt behind
you. Oh, the quilt behind me. So we're going to talk about our new patterns coming out, because these are indeed on the way. They are at the printers, and we just got notification this morning that they are shipping out in the next few days to us. So we will have printed patterns in stock. But this is our Colourwerx collection that you see right behind me. And this is our labyrinth pattern. And then it's another labyrinth pattern sample on the other side, which is done with Andover Fabrics Phosphor collection, which gives you an idea of what it looks like, I guess, in the solids. If I go this way, can you see that?
Yeah.
So that is what it looks like in the solids. If you wanted to do all solids, like Kona cotton solids or batik solids or something like that. And then this gives you an idea of what it looks like with our Colourwerx collection, or if you're using a printed fabric. So let's go to those patterns right now. These three patterns are coming out October 1st. So if you're on our newsletter list, or your subscriber to our newsletter, you'll get kind of a heads up they're coming in. They will be available, I'm saying pre-ordering, on October 1st. I do have an inkling that they might be here on October 1st, but I don't want to promise that based on the way shipping is going right now. So we know they're on their way, but you know, that's kind of at the mercy of UPS and FedEx and things like that. So the first one is Labyrinth there, you see, and I'm going to show you some different, I was going to go through them there. There we go. Well, the first one is Labyrinth. There, Carl clicked too fast. But that shows you some different colorways in Labyrinth. So this is a wonderfully fun pattern. It's 12 half yards. That's all you need, plus background fabric, plus your border fabric. And you can see a couple different versions there. So on the very right-hand side, if you wanted to do more of a monochromatic approach, that would be what it looks like. That's in purple, beautiful purple batiks from Hoffman. The middle one is some new lava solid batiks from Wyndham. And then the one that's on the left-hand side kind of gives you an idea of if you used kind of a different muted solid palette or things like that. So it's a wonderfully easy pattern to do. Each block is made exactly the same. Each half yard of fabric, again, you need 12, is cut exactly the same. And what you do is then you follow charts and mix up units. So you're creating different block combinations, block one combination, block two combination, block three combination of the different colors or fabrics. And so you do have to have your wits about you when you put the units together in combinations. And then it's just a matter of piecing the same block kind of pattern over and over again to create your 12 labyrinth blocks, and it goes together in order like that. So it looks like they're interweaving and maze-like and things like that. So that's our first pattern coming out. The second one is it's Mod Squad. So this may not be for everybody, but we like it. And of course, you know, we love the 60s, 70s, kind of 80s culture out there, the groovy, mod stuff. And so Mod Squad pattern, you have full-size pattern shapes for all of these heads and sunglasses. They all have a name. We talked about it that on episode 43, if you wanted to go see that episode of Fab Friday. Up in our Colourwerx YouTube channel, you can actually see what we named all these and things like that, these guys. In the pattern, it has both the instructions for the wall hanging, which you see on the far left, and that's some of Teresa's beautiful quilting that she did in there. You can also make a pillow if you want to, or put several heads on a pillow or a tote bag. And then there is a layout for a lap quilt too. So if you're really into Mod Squad characters, then you could make a lap quilt out of 15 of your favorite characters, and it kind of gives you a layout there. So that's Mod Squad. That's our second pattern coming. And the third one, of course, which ties into our tutorial today, is Topaz. And this is another wonderful wonderfully kind of fun pattern that Carl designed, and it's it got a little bit of precision piecing going on with it. It's got some piecing, patchwork piecing, and it's also got paper piecing, which is what today's tutorial is all about. Now, before we move on to today's tutorial, we're going to go and talk about a little bit about Halloween, because as you know, I love Halloween, so I have several Linderella Halloween patterns, but I do have two that are left over, and they are these, which are up on our website at colourwerx.com. So if you're looking for something fun to do for Halloween, and I know some of you guys have already done this, you know, if for your decoration on Halloween, the Happy Jacks pattern is still up there, and the Ragtag and Boo Tail pattern. These are like at a special price of $5, as well as all of our Linderella patterns. So again, just because we're about a month away from Halloween, you're looking maybe for something different. Maybe you want to do some applique, which is what these are. Both Happy Jacks and Ragtag and Boo Tail are still available. We still have these, some printed patterns left in stock from Linderella's, as well as some other Linderella choice patterns up there. So with that, I think, is that all the news? It is, Carl.
I think so. Yeah.
Unless anybody has any burning questions, we're going to start with Carl's tutorial because, like I said, it's a step-by-step tutorial on paper piecing, and he pre-recorded it. So if you have questions, go ahead and put them in the comments on the side, you know, under the Facebook, or if you have, if you're watching us on YouTube later, put your questions below, and then we will answer them after the video tutorial. So basically what Carl did is he did step-by-step tutorial on this triangle pattern shape, which is part of topaz, and he's going to take you there. Thank you so much, Carl. Right on cue, the topaz pattern. And he's going to take you step-by-step through paper piecing. So if you need a refresher on paper piecing, this is a great little tutorial. If you've never paper pieced before, this is a great tutorial. And if you're interested in buying the topaz pattern, well, my goodness, then you're all set up because you've got a tutorial to refer to right away to help you get through paper piecing. So roll it, Carl.
So here we go with the paper piecing. The first thing we need is the paper piecing template. And there we go. This is the one for topaz. You print this out at 100%. Do not scale to fit or it will not be the right dimension. Must print 100%. So let's take a quick look at the template before we move on. There's letters on this template and there's also numbers. The numbers refer to the steps where the pieces go down and which order. So the first piece goes to the second piece, then you put the third piece in, 4, 5, and 6. That is the order that you sew it together. There's actually sew lines on here to show you the sequence of the sew lines too. Now the letters refer to what the fabric is, which piece of fabric is going to be in which position. Fabric A is always in position 3, fabric B is always in position 2, 5 and 6 is always going to be fabric C. 1 and 4, that's where the fabric changes depending on the colorway. So depending on what the colorway says in the pattern, fabric 1 will either be H, L, P, or T, and it'll correspond with number 4, which is matching color, either G, K, O, and S. And this will tell you in the pattern which colorway goes where in which sequence. Anyway, so before we begin, as you see, this is a big piece of paper. I don't need all this piece of paper, so I'm actually going to trim a 1/4 inch beyond this solid line that's printed out just to get rid of the excess paper. So let's go ahead and do that. Just get my ruler. Just going to put my 1/4 inch marker on that. It doesn't have to be dead accurate. Just trim that line away. I have my paper template to start paper piecing. And as you can see, this has got all the instructions on this side. That is not the side we place the fabric. This is the only side. We flip it over to this side when we want to sew on these lines. Where we're actually going to place the fabric is on the back side. And as you can notice, there's no instructions. So what do we do? The first thing we're going to do is go back to the front side. I'm going to get a piece of tracing paper. And in this case, it's parchment paper because I couldn't find the tracing paper. And I'm actually going to trace this shape, these sew lines only, not the dotted lines. So I'm going to do the sew lines. I'm going to do the the thick line right there, which is the outside of the block itself, and the size of the paper that's already there is my traced out template and cut out. So it's exactly the same as the paper piece template. Now then, you'll notice I've got numbers on here. This is number one, this is number four. However, I need to reverse fabrics 3 and 2 because this is going to be on the other side of the template. So 3, which was here, is now going to be marked here on the freezer paper. Number 2 is marked there. The same with 5 and 6, reverse those numbers. 1 and 4 stays the same, the other ones reverse, because what's going to happen is we're going to work from this side of the template. And I'd like to see where everything lines up. So that's what I do when I'm paper piecing. I make myself a copy of a template that goes on the side that never has any instructions, just so I can get some instructions. How do we do this? Well, the first thing we're going to do now is I need piece number one. So piece number one is a blue square, according to the pattern. So I'm going to fold this in half. It's 5 by 5 square or thereabouts. I'm going to fold that in half. I'm going to place it, that crease, directly at the point of the template, because I know that's the first place, and along one of these lines on my cutting board, which means this is probably going to be parallel down here. That's a good start. Now then, as you can see, my next piece I need is number 2. But if you also notice, this fabric is the right side up, meaning you will see the right side of the fabric, not the wrong side. With batiks, it really doesn't matter, but when you do a printed fabric, this will be the right side. However, piece number 2, which comes in, which goes on top like that, and will match. It's going to get sewn across this line. I want to make sure that this edge of the fabric here is at least 1/4 inch beyond this edge. You don't want to go too wild. You don't want to go like 1 inch or 3/4, not even 1/2 inch, just between 1/4 inch and 1/2 inch. Line that fabric up there, so when you go to the sewing machine, you can confidently sew on that line. When it flips over, you've got enough fabric to cover the edge of the template. Again, now this fabric I've just put down is fabric number 2. However, this is the wrong side up. So this will be the right side. This is the wrong side. And that's how we start paper piecing. That's where people go wrong. They can never remember what side is up. Once we've reversed the paper right here to the back side, the only piece of fabric that's the right side up will be the first one. The rest of them, this will be the back side of the fabric. Whether it's a batik, doesn't really matter, or a solid, but a printed fabric, it will matter. So there we go. That's the back side. First thing we're going to do now is I'm just going to pin right here to secure these two fabrics through the paper like that. So I've kept my line where I'm going to sew. As you can see, it's through the paper right there. Fabric 1, fabric 2, which is B fabric, fabric 1, the blue fabric 2, which is the gray fabric, as per instructions. Now we're going to take this over to the sewing machine and sew it. What we're actually going to do when we get to the sewing machine, I'm just going to do what I did. We're going to flip it over. So remember, back side. Now we're going to go to the front side, flip it over. Now I'm going to sew across this line here, the solid line. It says sew line 1. That's where I'm going to sew. I'm going to start off the paper, come down and stop a few stitches below. That will be my first seam. So off to the machine we go. So we're ready to start sewing the first two pieces here together. I've already got my leader in there so I don't get no bird's nest going on with that bobbin thread. So here's my first two pieces. I'm going to sew on sew line number 1 right there on the solid line. So I've got my pieces in. I'm just going to give a quick check to make sure everything's laying flat so it doesn't turn up on itself. Let's lift the presser foot here. And I'm just going to start right on that solid line right there. Speed is up to you, but I wouldn't go speedy demon because it'll get a bit wobbly. So here we go. There you go. And as you've noticed, I've gone a couple of stitches beyond sew line number 3. So when I put this piece in number 4, and it's all captured. So what we're going to do now, I don't have a fancy cutter on this machine, so I have to lift my presser foot, pull the thread out before I finish. I'm going to pop a leader back in there. So I'm ready for the next piece. All I'm going to do now, I'm going to take this over to the cutting board and trim it up. So here we are back from the sewing machine. That's the first two pieces sewn. There's them stitched together. That's the sew line I was on. I sewed that piece, 1 to 2. Now I can take the pin out. Take that out. Next, I'm gonna flip it back to the front. And this is most important. Just flip back the paper only, where it's been stitched. You can crease it. That'll be easy because of the sewing and the thread in there. That'll make it easy. And then just continue with your finger down there to get that a nice straight line. What we're now gonna do is trim away this extra fabric that we don't need. So I'm just gonna, this is an add a quarter ruler. You don't need an add a quarter ruler. You can do it with your regular ruler. I just happen to have one around here. So I'm gonna do that. I'm now gonna give myself a quarter inch seam right there. Take that away. We'll fold that. That gets folded back out now. That paper does not get cut. It stays with the template all the way through. Do not cut your paper. The next thing I'm gonna do is gonna flip this over now. And what I'm gonna do is flip that back. That is my first two pieces sewn together. This is the right side. This is now the right side because remember, we sewed with the back side up, so the two right sides. I'm now gonna take this over to the iron and press that out. So here we are over at the ironing board now. We've got the seam up. I'm just gonna take the fabric, push it to the outside, roll it up there. I'm not trying to stretch it. I'm just giving it a little tuck there, and then I'm gonna just nicely press that out. No steam, just a dry iron, because I don't wanna get the template wet. If I do that, it's all gonna wrinkle and misshapen, so just a dry iron. And from there, we'll take that back over. Let's go to the stash. Get my fabric 3, which is this gray fabric. This is gonna go right here, somewhere in this orientation right here. That's why I've got the template right here. Because if I lay this on there, my sew line is this line right here. So I can match this fabric to be beyond the sew line. And just take your time, there's no rush. Just do that, take it in there. Sometimes what I'll do is I'll do that. I need a bit more control over it and I want to be a bit more finicky, I'll just take some tweezers, just regular tweezers. And as you can see, there's the sew line and this is the edge of my fabric here. So I've got plenty of seam there. Plus I've left enough fabric when it flips over, it covers the edge of the template. So again, remove that, grab a pin, pin it to the fabric, to the template, just like that. Well, we smooth it out, make sure there's no wrinkles, and make sure that if you put your pin in like this, that the head is clear of a quarter inch down here from when you're sewing. And with that, we'll take that to the sewing machine and sew sew line 2. There we go, back from the machine. We've just stitched sew line 2 right there. Now what I'm gonna flip this over, remove that pin, we don't need it. Then we're gonna go back to the front side, right there. And as you see, we need to crease along sew line 2, right there, because I need to fold this back. We've also got a cross line of number 1 there. Well, tear that away. Don't tear the stitches, just the paper, so it's easy to flip. Crease it down, nice and good. Keep that as straight as you can, that line down there. And if need to, I don't have nails anymore because I got them clipped, so I'm just gonna use some tweezers to clip that one back out of the way. Doesn't matter if you cut that off, it's not necessary to keep there. I just like the template intact most of the way through. Trim that off. Over to the machine and do sew line number 3. Again, back from machine, just sew line 3 over there. So when we flip it over, it looks like that. Again, this will be the back side of the fabrics, all these. Let's take the pin out. Now what I'm gonna do, I need to flip it back the other way because now we're gonna bend this piece of the template out of the way so we can trim it to a quarter inch. Now with this one, because you've got crossing lines again, you are gonna have to break the paper, not the threads, just the paper. just like that. Just give it a little tug. That's okay if the paper rips like that. You don't need the paper at this point. You can just do that. And if you want to be a bit fussy, just like me sometimes, I'll just want to get that paper out of the way. Again, I'm not ripping the stitches, just the paper. Now this time, because my 1/4 ruler isn't long enough, I'm going to use my regular ruler to trim this down. And you can use this ruler all the way through the process. You do not need the 1/4 inch ruler. You just use your regular ruler, just like that. Again, I'm lined up on the edge of the paper that's folded. This is going to leave me 1/4 inch seam allowance right there. Sew line number 4. Back from the ironing board, just ready to put in the last piece now, which is number 6. Take it over the sewing machine and sew the final seam, this piece of the template, which is sew line number 5. And there, right there, is a paper pieced quadrant. 4 of these will make the block in the topaz quilt, but they're all done exactly the same. The only things that change are gonna be these colors here. So the next thing to do is flip this over. And what we want to see is the line we're going to cut this out on is going to be the solid line here, not the dotted line. That's when they get sewn together. So the next thing is to trim all the way down this solid line. And what you want to do before you trim is just to make sure that you've got fabric beyond that line all the way around, which we do. At that point, you're safe. You've got enough fabric. You can just go ahead and trim that up, and you'll be set to go. I'm gonna show you one that I trimmed earlier, a different colorway, because I don't like to trim mine down until they're all done, all sewn, and then I'll trim them down all together, so I'm trimming down the exact same thing all the time. But if you can imagine, this is just a different colorway, but it's the same piece, just like that. So if I was to trim that down, that's what I just did. Cut the sides away, voila. One paper pieced block.
There you go. So that was Carl's tutorial. Let us know if you have any questions about that in the comments. Carl, when you edited that, so the Caribbean music was very catchy and lively. What were you thinking about with the Caribbean music?
Well, the reason that was in there is we had a package that was lost by FedEx, which was a rather large package going to one of our distributors.
Yes.
So I called customer service and they routed me to the Caribbean.
Ah.
So I'm talking to the people in the Caribbean that seem very happy and peppy. Not very helpful with the package that was missing, but they were happy and peppy.
Okay.
And that was in my mind.
Well, you know, we always have to put some type of music in there, because I don't know about you guys, but when I watch video tutorials, nothing drives me more crazy than silence, when people are like, you know, they speed up their sewing just because they don't need to show you real time what they're doing. You kind of know what they're doing, so you can speed up the film. But it drives me crazy when it's just silent. So we always try to put some kind of lively, jivey music, you know, to keep the video moving along.
But the
Caribbean music was, you know, very good. It was lively. I just wanted to know why you chose it. So let us know if you have any comments. So this is the actual unit that Carl was working on in the tutorial, step by step. And I wanted to show you this. We have pinned up like what 4 would look like. So this is part of the topaz pattern, coming out for pre-order on October 1st. Thank you, Carl. And so that is 4 triangles put together. Of course, I haven't sewn them together yet because we're getting some other things ready on the quilt sample before we do it. But once I sew these four units together, and of course, you want to keep all your paper on your paper piecing templates or on your units until you get everything sewn in. The paper comes off the very last step once the quilt top is completely sewn together is usually my rule of thumb. But this would then sneak in. These are all, you would have more of a pinwheel effect here. This is showing its quarter inch seams here. So I see that we have some comments there. Let's see, Nancy goes, great tutorial, Carl.
Thank you, Nancy.
Yes, and Mary says, very good. I might be brave enough to try paper piecing. You should try it. And you know, with Christmas coming on, there's a lot of free paper piecing tutorial, paper piecing patterns out there. So my feeling is, if you have never tried it, just go try it.
It's the principles.
I love it. Everything that Carl talked about in this tutorial is the same regardless of what pattern you're choosing. So it's good to have. Just try it. You'll like it. That way you have it in your, thanks, Kimberly. Kimberly says, excellent tutorial, Carl. But my feeling is once you should never discount any technique, because once you try it and you learn it, it may not be your favorite technique in the world, but at least it's in your, what I call the skill is in your quilting arsenal going forward. So if you do want to use it, you have the knowledge to go ahead and do it. So that is my feeling. We never discount any techniques, and we never discount, of course, any color here at Colourwerx. So what Bob says, love Fab Fridays. Thank you, Robert.
And Pat,
am I the only one experiencing pauses in the video and speech? I do not know. So you guys will have to tell us. We are not experiencing hits here, but then we are watching ourselves kind of on a video monitor as we go out to you. So that very well could be that we are having interruptions across the country at this point. Because goodness knows the country is having interruptions itself at this point. So, I had no pauses, Marianne says. And then Suzanne says, no, I thought it was me. So are you having pauses, I guess?
I think some people are not.
Right. So anyway, this is, I'll just continue on. This is the topaz block that's paper pieced in the pattern. This is the pieced block. So you can see it's super easy, the pieced block. So there's two different blocks in the topaz pattern that make up the topaz quilt. And this is as hard as it gets. So you have a very simple pieced block. You could actually fussy cut something in the middle here if you didn't want to do that little pinwheel block there, or half square triangle block. If you wanted to fussy cut out a full piece of fabric or frame something, you could. And then you have, you know, the paper piece block that Carl just did the tutorial on. So you guys are very nice. Thank you for all your kind comments. Thank you, Heidi, for liking our patterns. And remember,
Marian liked my tutorial.
Well, thank you, Marian.
She's going to be brave enough to try it.
Yeah, you guys should. And remember that those patterns are going to be available for pre-order. All three patterns, Labyrinth, Mod Squad, and Topaz, will be available to pre-order in either a PDF. Well, the PDF will be available right away on October 1st. And if you want a paper pattern, that will be available for pre-ordering or ordering on October 1st, too. And if you order all three patterns together, and I'll have one of those items where you can order all three together, you'll get a discount on each pattern. So if Carl goes to that page, yep, there you go. If you order all three patterns, you'll get a discount of like $2 off a pattern. I think it's going to be 3 for $30 at that point. So that is it. Let's see the question.
Well, let's see.
What? Jen says,
Jen's going to have a go.
Great pattern. Maybe I'll even try it. You guys should try paper piecing. I'm surprised so many people are scared of paper piecing.
It is fun.
What you have to do, and we used to teach this at Lindarella's, when you start to paper piece, you really do have to kind of wrap your brain around the fact that you're working in reverse. You're sewing from the printed side, but you're actually laying all your fabric up on the unprinted side, which is where Carl's tutorial was actually so clever, because he actually made that little parchment paper template and laid it on the non-printed side of the pattern, not this side, but this side, laid it on the non-printed side, so he knew exactly where to line up all his pieces, so he wasn't really wasting any fabric. A lot of times I actually would get confused. You know, I'm looking at this side and I'm saying I need to put down, you know, fabric number three, and then you get the angle wrong. You know, the angle goes the opposite direction because you haven't reversed your brain yet of where you are back here. So that's why the template really helps that Carl did, because you don't have any confusion about which way the sew line is when you're laying your pieces right sides together. And that's the whole thing. So,
and you can use that on any paper piece template.
And you can use that on anything, any paper piece template.
And
share that tutorial with all your friends. Make sure that you hit the share button here right below me or above me. And make sure that you like and obviously share or subscribe to our Colourwerx YouTube channel. So the question of the week or the question of the month is for a Colourwerx gift card. We're going to go back to giving away $10 Colourwerx gift cards. Oh. Is paper piecing, is it your thing? This is Carl's question. Is it your thing?
I didn't know what else to call it.
Let us know. Well, yeah.
What? Is it?
Do you like it? You know, does it agree with you? All that stuff.
Wait,
so now, are we going back to the cactus camp for a minute?
People out there.
Oh, golfers!
It's going gray. Like we
that. Is that the golfers going through? Yes, people are still golfing even though they're letting the grass dry out. They actually are going to do what's called a Dust Bowl tournament. When the grass gets really dry, probably next week, at the end of next week, they do what's called the Dust Bowl golfing tournament, which is kind of fun to watch because everybody get, you know, there's dust flying, and when they hit the ball, there's lots of grass flying and things like that. So anyway, so we are going to be back with you guys. Okay, so we don't really know when we're going to be back.
Well,
so
for sure, for Halloween.
We know we're going to be back for sure October 29th, which is the couple days prior to Halloween. So we'll do like a Halloween special like we did last year. But we might try to be back October 15th. But here's the problem. We are headed deep into the heart of Texas in the middle of October to go meet some very famous quilty people, because we're going to be...
Not Quilt Market, because that was canceled.
No, it's not Quilt Market. It's actually, these are quilty people that you will know. They're very recognizable people. And we have been asked to go meet them deep in the heart of Texas to do some
fun things
and some filmy things for some shows. So we are getting ready to do that. We're going to be taking a road trip out to Texas right in the middle of October. So and it will be right after October 15th. So if we can manage it, now this is the other crazy thing. I've got to go to jury duty October 4th.
Before that.
So hopefully I can get out of jury. Like hopefully they don't like me and I'll be excused and all this other stuff. But yeah, so you know, let's just pile it all on in October. So we have jury duty. We have you know,
Texas.
This thing we're doing in Texas and Austin. We might try to be on Fab Friday October 15th. But if we don't see you October 15th, we are definitely going to see you October 29th for a Halloween special. So that's kind of the news. But we will let everybody know via our Facebook and Instagram, and also via the newsletter and all that stuff when we're coming back on for Fab Friday. It's not going away. It just might be 5 weeks apart versus four or three at this point, depending on what our schedules do. So that is basically our program today. You guys have been so nice to hang with us on this Fab Friday of September 24th. This is episode 44. I want you all to have a glorious day out there. Fall is here. It's feeling great. And a happy, colorious quilting to you all. Happy weekend, everybody. Thank you.